Thank you for your speak. And so tell us a little bit about Neve Shalom, the place you live in.
Neve Shalom is an intentional community based in Israel, right in the middle between Tel Aviv and Jerusalem. It's most likely the only place in Israel where Jews and Palestinians live together side by side by choice and inequality. It's about 200 and some people in the community. The place was formed in the 70s by a priest.
By a priest?
Yeah.
Jews, Palestinians, he came by a priest.
He was born Jew. He said that he found God, Bruno Hauser was his name. He said that he found God through Jesus.
Okay.
And the Vatican sent him to Israel to learn the Hebrew text. And when he arrived, he had this vision of building a place that would be safe and a place for all three religions basically to grow. And he started pitching the idea, and the Latour Monastery gave him this hip, and he formed the Veshano.
And why do people want to live there or decide to join the community in the Veshano?
Actually, it's a very, there's a high demand for people to live there. I think for a lot of us, it just makes sense. You know, kids learn Arabic from kindergarten and Hebrew. You become much more aware of sort of the other side, you know. And I think there's something that it's sort of, I feel it's sort of like a cure, you know. Just knowing that I'm in this place, that there's this intention, you don't necessarily need to be like a peace activist. But honestly, it just makes sense, you know, living together and spending time together and understand cultures and even understand the difference and gaps.
And what are the values or the things that allow this community to stay together, to keep together, and not to be involved in all the conflict that is happening around them?
First of all, there are a lot of complexities, of course. Whenever you use big words such as shalom, you know, peace is a big word. It could be sometimes a burden on the shoulders of the community. Because first of all, you need to have the everyday life, you know, throwing the garbage, taking care of the parking spots or whatever, or houses. And then you have this all political story, which is political. So it's first of all, it's complex. There's a lot of complexities. But I think if there's something that is in common, you think this is strong will for coexistence, you know. In order for it to succeed, and you know how they say that you need to make the change, you need to be the change, you need to be the change you want to see in the world. So I think it's sort of like that.
Okay. And you're one of the organizers of Meet the Burn,
yeah.
The Burning Man,
Israel.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how? What about that community? How's that community being built? What brings that community together? What makes you a community, like the Midburn community?
First of all, Midburn is a world phenomenon. Midburn has grew, in 2 years it's become the second largest regional event for Burning Man out of 65 different events that are happening around the world. It's the fastest growing burners community in the world today, and it's become the largest creative community in Israel. We have about 30,000 active profiles in our system. So it's thriving, it's successful, it gains a lot of attention. And I think it's two powers that basically glue this community together. I think one is creation and creativity. And creativity doesn't mean necessarily that I'm doing art, you know, or build an art piece. I can create concepts, you know. We value creativity, and the second thing is giving back, you know, and being creative and giving back, I think, is the two things that make us grow as human beings. So you have a lot of people that put their intention into basically giving and create. It creates something really special, and people's lives are changing, you know, we're all growing from that.
Of course. You've seen all, or you have studied many communities around the world, right? So what are the main main points that you can address that are being taken part of the community in a daily basis, in a successful community? Like, what issues do you think are the most important in a successful community?
I think first of all, an agreed set of values. You could say a vision, but sometimes vision is a big word or a heavy word to use. But an agreed set of values. This is a value that we appreciate.
Okay.
Not necessarily laws, but values. I think it has to be playful. And by playful, I also mean creative. The more creativity you'd see, the stronger the ties in the community.
By playful, you mean like that people should express themselves as they believe they are, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And being accepted in their creativity, allowed to create something, whatever, you know.
Okay.
I think decentralization is something that I come across in many communities that are actually working. There's no one voice, one governor. Everybody's are included. Everybody have a sense of ownership on their experience.
Okay.
And if it, the more the individual have a space, how do you create a community that basically gives space to the individual? It's a very complex issue, but by allowing an individual enough space to grow as part of a group of the community, would make the community more sustainable.
Not trying to shape.
Exactly.
And well, to feed the community, more
exactly.
That
inspire
and
exactly.
Give freedom to
everybody.
Okay, so thank you very much.
Thank
you for being in Mexico.
Thank you for having me.
Hope we can work together.